Let's now shift our attention to the other big story that we are tracking on Vyond, where toughening its stand on the European Union COVID certificates. India has asked the Eurozone to accept Covishield or Covaxin, or else India will not accept the bloc's digital green pass. The people from the European Union will have to undergo a mandatory quarantine upon arrival in India, even if they've been vaccinated. However, isolation for those carrying the EU's digital pass will not be required, only if Brussels were to accept India's Covaxin and Covishield vaccines. Now, earlier, the European Union did not accept the two Made in India vaccines for its green pass. The bloc has listed only those vaccines that have been approved by the European Medicines Agency. Now, the vaccine certificate will be rolled out today. The vaccines that have been approved by EMA, that is the European Medical Agency, are Pfizer, Moderna, AstraZeneca and Janssen, but Covishield, which is the Indian version of AstraZeneca, is yet to get the European clearance. The exclusion of vaccines being administered in India has sparked concerns that Indians will face some pretty big difficulties if they have to travel to the European Union, which has 27 member nations. All right, now to get us more updates on what all of this, of course, means, we are joined in by Vyond's Siddhant Sibal, who's joining us live on this broadcast. Vyond, this is an interesting and a pretty strong stance that India has taken with the EU there.
Well, yes, a strong stance, but also urging EU member states. But at the heart of the entire confusion lies the use of the European Medicines Agency's list, the list that only lists four vaccines and not India-made vaccines, whether it's Covishield or Covaxin. The European Union could have used the World Health Organization's list as well. But the problem was, amongst the EU member countries, there was a division on allowing the Chinese vaccines. And that is why, if they would have gone for WHO's list, that means automatically giving approval to the Chinese vaccine. So that is why they used the EMA. Now coming to India's contention, India is now reaching out to all EU member countries bilaterally and with the European Union also. We know that just a few days ago, the Indian External Affairs Minister had met his European counterpart on the sidelines of the G20 FM's meeting in Italy, in which he had raised the matter. But bilaterally, India has told everyone, all the countries, that it's high time they accept Covishield. Firstly, this is an AstraZeneca vaccine, and there is a hindsight to it. There, in the past, in fact, there was a request by countries in that bloc to get that same very vaccine made here in India by the Serum Institute. And now, of course, this controversy coming out, but it's largely stemming from the larger confusion, which, of course, European Union is keen to resolve.
Absolutely, indeed. And one of the key concerns of this entire controversy about the acceptance of Indian-made vaccines by the European Union are students from India who have to travel perhaps to the European Union nations for their higher studies. At this point of time, any resolution on that front, Siddhant?
Well, as of now, European Union is not allowing anyone to come to the bloc. There are restrictions by many countries. So it's not just the students, but other sector also who are very, very keen to go to European Union, whether it's for work, whether for education. Now, coming for, of course, the so-called vaccine passport, there is a huge controversy on whether the India-made vaccines can be allowed. For this, India is engaging at two fronts. First, bilaterally with as many countries as it's possible, whether it's the bloc or whether it's other countries. Secondly, India is keen that the World Health Organization list, in which Covishield is already listed, gets Covaxin as well on its list. As of now, World Health Organization, the list lists eight vaccines, which includes Chinese vaccines as well. In fact, it does not include Sputnik. Sputnik has given the documents, and we do expect Sputnik to get the approval very soon. So largely internationally, whenever there is a consensus on the so-called vaccine passport, rest assured, when it comes to Covishield, there will be no worry. It's about Covaxin, on which Indian government is engaging with World Health Organization. In fact, there was a meeting of Bharat Biotech officials who gave the documents to the World Health Organization.
All right, we'll have to leave it there. Thank you very much indeed, Siddhant Sibal, for joining us and getting us all those updates there. Vyond is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news on the move.